Yama. Heart to heart, we stand. No promises, no demands. Love is a battlefield.
How many of us, I wonder, can recall that childhood moment when we experienced happiness as a state of being, that single moment of untarnished joy, that moment when everything in our world, inside and out, was all right. Everything was all right.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the channel. This is where we study the 12 laws of mind that govern our lives and the one that overrides them all and their principle. Good to know about principle, so it doesn't bite your ass. But anyways, today I got a question from a very wonderful patron. She's great. And she asked the following question. And it's, what's the difference between feeling and emotion? Is there a difference? And the answer to that question is, yes, there is a difference between feeling and emotion. Okay, so feeling means touching. You can feel that, right? You're conscious of feeling yourself touching something, right? And you're conscious of feeling the texture of whatever that is. You're aware of that, okay? And there's no emotion to it. It's a feeling, okay? And the an emotion is, this feels really good. You know, I just love how this feels. This feels so good. I don't want to give it up. I don't want to ever give it up. Okay. Shun, T-I-O-N, S-I-O-N, means state of being. Emo means blood, okay? It means in a state of blood. You're being a bleeding heart. Yes, there is a difference. In pain and suffering, you're reacting, okay? And feeling is being aware, okay? I am aware I'm feeling angry. You know, not I am angry. And this is, you know, what we're told, be aware of the name of God and how you're using it, all right? It's your name. I am the Supreme Being, which holds us all and is inside us all, which is the presence, okay, is everywhere. So if you say I am, he goes, here you go, okay? And the feeling is appreciation, admiration, respect, with calm, quiet confidence is how we're told. Okay, but that's how they perceive that love. If you read the Bible, it says like the love that a mother has for her child, for a baby, for a pet, you know, is that kind of love. That feeling, okay? And so that means if you just think about it, admiration, appreciation, and respect. I admire you. I appreciate you and respect you. I don't think like you, and that's okay. But you're a soldier too, in the trenches. It's not for me to, you know, stop you from your mission.
Private Benitez, New York. You study Shakespeare?
Drill Sergeant, yes, Drill Sergeant.
All right, let me hear some.
Go!
I said I want to hear some. Let's go.
You keep it down, don't move.
He that lives.
Come on, what? What was that? I can't hear. Come on, go!
He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand a tiptoe when this day is named. and rouse him at the name of Crispian.
I didn't tell you to stop. Keep going. Keep going. Go!
He that shall live this day and see old age will yearly on the vigil feast his neighbors and say, tomorrow is St. Crispian. Then will he strip his sleeves, show his scars, and say, these wounds I had on St. Crispian's day. Old men forget, yet all shall be forgot. But he'll remember with advantages what feats he did that day. Then shall our names, familiar in his mouth as household words, Harry the King, Bedford and Exeter, Warwick and Talbot, Salisbury and Gloucester, being their flowing cups freshly remembered. And this story shall the good man teach his son, and Crispian Crispian shall ne'er go by from this day to the ending of the world, but we in it shall be remembered. We few, we happy few, we band of brothers. For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother.
We're all on mission. And that mission is to experience God, life, as a human. All right. And to see if they're, you know, having a good time. And appreciating, admiring, and respecting life. And guiding them that way if they're not. You know, and helping others realize we're here to experience life as a human being. Okay, I'm being human. I'm not a human being. So we're here to experience life. We're a spirit. We're given this astronaut suit, you know, and it works perfectly. Not a darn thing wrong with it. It came out of the Supreme Being, the presence, the force, the one. Okay, and you are the Christ during the day, but you are now conscious that you are that, came out of that being and have all his traits, because you're never not connected, right? And it's, you don't do it for Rita, you do it for the one in your heart, because he's in all men's hearts. No, so you feel admiration, appreciation, respect. You don't emote things like anger when love is split in two. It's happy and sad, you know, and it's us fracturing that, and you have to pull it back together. It's all love. It's all admiration, appreciation, respect. So the other question is, what is feeling delusional? And feeling delusional is awareness of being in a state of delusion, illusion, you know, that you're now aware, okay, this feels like crazy. This feels delusional. You're not, you know, emoting, you know, crazy woman. Somebody puts an emotion to that. Okay. So, no, it's just, no. You feel that way and you just change it. No, there's only love. That came out of love. I don't believe that. I have admiration, appreciation, respect. It's all going to work out fine. You know, and this is you trusting in God, who is in all, and everything works your way when you do that. So I hope this helps. A feeling is you're consciously aware of it and you're paying attention. Okay. Attention on the human side is you're giving something your attention, you're giving it your admiration, appreciation, and respect. Now, if you don't like it, why are you giving it your attention? Okay, because you're in a state of attending, attention. Okay, how are you paying attention? All right, with admiration, the feeling is the secret. Admiration, appreciation, and respect. Okay, and that's it. I know it's not going to work out. I know it doesn't matter if I don't do anything at my house all day except, you know, this, that, or the other. Whatever it is you've been beating yourself up about. You know, I accept who I am. I'm the greatest. Okay, I'm here to experience being human. So I hope this helps. And I hope it makes you think anyway. A feeling is something you're very conscious of, and an emotion is a reaction. So, and you're bleeding, you're hurting yourself, you're cutting yourself. So it's best to step back and not do that and start talking to yourself about yourself in third person and telling yourself you're a spirit. I'm not this body. You know, I'm spirit. Take a breath in when you say I'm not this body and breath out when you say I am spirit. And then, I mean, totally exhale, empty all your breath out, and then stay there like that for a moment or two. You know, it gets it across to the mind. You're not the body. You're spirit. Okay. And usually things will start really falling into place. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. And thank you. Thank you for being you.
Just forget about coming back.